Today I want to talk about Mindly. It's an iOS app that purports to do visual mapping, and it actually does it in a bit of a neat way. I'm going to go through, review it, tell you what I like, what I don't like, and maybe give you some ideas about whether this might be useful for you or maybe not. So with that in mind, let's do it. Hey everyone, Kevin here. Now, I want to just go through some of the things about Mindly. It's an iOS app. There's a free version and there's also a paid version as well, $6.99 to upgrade to the paid version. So I'll talk about that in a little bit. Let's go in. I want to show you a little bit about what it does. If you start out with the free version, you'll get three different maps. And you can make the maps gigantic down below that, but you have three different topics. I'm going to go into my Mindly review. The first thing I'm going to go over is how this thing works. Now you can see I've got my main idea, my Mindly review, and I've created three separate topics around there. You can grab this, I can spin it around, make it look cool. I'm going to go into the specs area first. I'm just going to tap it. Oh, there we go. Try to tap it. There we go. You can see in specs, I've got a couple of things. I've got a little thumbs up sign there. It might be a little small depending on how big your screen is you're looking at. I'm going to double click on the specs. That's going to take me into the area where I can add content. So I can, beyond just having a map, I can add notes inside of that map as well. And that's a neat thing to have in any visual mapping program that you're using. I'm going to tap the check mark to get back. And I want to show you just how deep this can go. So I'm going to click on the next, and next, and next. And you can keep going down, 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 down. So when you get to the appropriate level of the node that you want, you can go ahead and add something else if you want, more information if you want. You can tap on any of the plus signs that are around next. I'm going to click on that one right there. I'm just going to say hello. And I'll hit next. Now, usually there it goes. It'll allow me to add some more information. So I can add any extra info you want. Once you've finished adding information, you can either go ahead and you can select some colors. They just added some new bright colors as well, but it's just more color. So I'll pick a different color just to show you. And then icons. So there's tons of different icons. I'll just scroll up and down a little bit, but there's several different categories. And once you go into the category, there are obviously several more. How about this? Everyone likes a sunny day. Let's put a sunny icon in there. And then I'll hit the check mark, which will get me back to that. And you can see it just added my new space. If I want to get back in, all I do is where it says hello, the blue dot, I just double tap on that. Tap, tap. Takes me back in. If I need to get back out, just hit the check mark again and I'm good to go. Now when I want to go back, I just hit the upper left hand corner. So next, back, upper left, and keep going up until I find what I'm looking for. Something that's pretty cool about this is you can add pictures right into your map. So let's go in and let's add a picture to our map. I'm going to click on that. The way to add pictures is to just, if you look at the upper right hand corner, it looks almost like a little image. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be a picture or a photo or what it is. I'm going to tap on that. I'm going to say take photo and I'll give you a picture of my keyboard. There you go. Perfect. And use photo and it inserts it. If you look in the upper right corner, you can see that now there's a tiny minuscule picture of my keyboard. If you're using a phone, you can obviously see it a little bit better. It's awful tiny though. But so all we need to do is press and hold and we can drag that thing down. So let's try. There we go. And as I get close to the plus sign, you can see it turn blue off and back and forth. I guess it's actually a circle right now because I'm dragging it. So it's telling me exactly where it's going to go. I'm just going to release it on there. And there we go. Copy here. Yes, copy there. From here, if I want to see the image, all I do is I just double tap. Tap, tap, and there's my image. Close it when I'm done. So that's kind of a neat thing as well, to have the ability to go in and quickly take images of things. Maybe you're doing a product comparison or you're studying and you're trying to add new information. I want to go over a couple of things that I do like about Mindly. Let's go ahead and have a quick look. Like I talked about, the ability to add notes. And I do like the ability to have, like I already mentioned, have images added. There's a little selfie, even with my selfie pouty face. Thought you guys would enjoy that. I like the fact that you can spin it. It's just, if you want to have a bit of a different direction, or maybe you want something at the top or on the side, you can just grab it and spin it and you're good to go. So it's just a neat little thing that you can do. And it just looks cool too. I do like how Mindly turned out because it was designed to be used on a mobile device. And the circles do work well with limited screen real estate. Something else that's pretty cool is they have a working view, which this is the working view where we go in and see the detail like this. They also have a mind map view. Now, if we go down to the bottom right, there's a little up arrow. We're going to tap on that. And they give us a couple of options. The home button just takes us back to that home screen. But when I click on the mind map button, it shows me my mind map in real time. So it sees it shows everything. And I can come here and zoom in and out and have a quick look. This is a cool way just to see the relationships between different objects, as well as the depth that your visual map goes. So you can see right here, here's the one we added. Here's the note we added a while ago, that hello note. I'll just zoom right in and there we go. So pretty neat. And then when we're done, we can go back to the working view. The emojis, I already showed you them as well. You can add a couple things, add a smiley face, add some images. They're pretty tiny, but it's neat to have some of those things. And it's another way to help you say more with fewer words. Let's go back a little bit. So let's talk about a couple of things now that I'm not as much of a fan of. The upgrade price is $6.99, which that's a little bit pricey as far as app standards go. Now, when you upgrade, what it does is it lets you create more than three maps. And the other thing it does is when I hit share, it unlocks a few more of the ways that we can share. So you can see it as of right now, with the free version, you can either email it as a Mindly file or PDF. The text option is completely locked out. And if you plan on using this with a laptop or with your home computer, you're going to need probably a text option or an HTML option, something to get this information out of here, because there's no web interface, there's no desktop client. So either you're all on the phone or you've got no way across, unless you go ahead and you pay for the upgrade and you get the option to have text or HTML. So there's your decision, whether you want to leave it on the phone. If you do, you've got three maps, you can make three gigantic maps. So that's one thing. Let's move on. Something else that I'm not a huge fan of is zooming. You can't zoom in. I wish I could just grab two fingers and just drag it out. I'm dragging it out right now. It's not working. You can't zoom in the work view, which I think would be neat sometimes, just even for some of those emojis, some of those images, that instead of having to double click on an image and look at the whole image, I could just zoom in a little bit and see a bit more of it. But I understand they're trying to make it as simple as possible and still make it functional. The obvious limitation to the free version, like I mentioned already, is that you can save only as a PDF or as a .mindly file. So this will be okay if this is the only place you're going to have it, but whenever you want to transfer information out, this is going to hamstring you unless you go ahead and you upgrade to the full version. That's my initial impression of Mindly. I like it. It's a really neat app. I just think that maybe if it was more in the $3 to $4 to $5 range, I'm more likely to call it a buy, because everyone likes cheap apps. But for $7, it's really not that big of a deal. If you want to go ahead and if this works for you, check it out. Drop the $7, and I think you'll be actually really happy with going with it. It's kind of a neat app. If you're interested in going deeper with visual maps, check out Visual Productivity. Just follow along as I walk you through business, personal, and learning topics step by step. Head over to yourmakingme.com to check it out.